The safety of students is always a top priority for schools, but keeping school employees injury-free is just as important. Employee injuries are costly in terms of pain, suffering, lost time, and increased workers' compensation insurance rates. Missouri Employers Mutual reports that the average lost time workers' compensation claim costs is $28,000. Some of the most commonly reported school employee injuries include vehicle crashes, slips and trips that result in falls, overexertion resulting in strains or sprains, food service accidents, including cuts and burns. School administration must commit to providing a safe workplace. This begins with employees in leadership positions serving as safety champions of their school and make requiring that other employees work safely as well. When unsafe acts or conditions are discovered, it is up to school leaders to make sure the situation is remedied as soon as possible. All departments in the school system should have a safety program that begins with written safety rules, including custodial, food service, transportation, and educators. Safety rules should be clear, written, communicated, and enforced. Written safety rules should include a seatbelt policy, post-injury drug and alcohol testing, regular safety inspections, and slip, trip, and fall prevention. Education and communication are vital components of a safety plan. Full and part-time employees and volunteers should receive workplace safety messages regularly. Educate employees about ways to prevent common injuries experienced in school settings, including slips, trips, strains, sprains, and interfacing with children. Use email or text messages to communicate safety messages. This is especially important when working conditions are subject to change or inclement weather is approaching. Perform routine inspections of classrooms, storage areas, hallways, and kitchens. Look for unsafe conditions like leaking pipes, water on the floor, ice, or trip hazards. Make sure fire exits are unblocked and unlocked. Maintain severe weather shelter areas so they are ready for use at any moment. Train employees to perform routine inspections and provide the tools they need to correct any unsafe conditions or hazards right away. Inspections find hazards before they find your employees. Should an incident occur, prompt reporting is key to successful claim management. MEM recommends that all incidents be documented and submitted to the workers' compensation insurer within 24 hours of occurrence, even if the employee refuses medical treatment. All school employees, including substitute teachers and part-time staff, should know the requirements for incident reporting. Missouri statutes and your insurers support your safety efforts. When safety rules and equipment are provided, trained and enforced, and an employee is injured as a result of not following safety rules or wearing protective equipment, there could be a penalty on disability benefits. This is also true for positive drug or alcohol tests where a written drug-free workplace policy is in effect. Increased effort in the safety of your school's employees can yield monetary savings and keep your employees at work and injury-free. Learn more about how to prevent workplace injuries in schools by visiting worksafecenter.com and checking out our school safety tutorial.